Das ist an die Britta selber, es ist an sie, und jeder schaut, Halleluja! Let's celebrate Jesus. Celebrate the King of Kings. Let's celebrate the Almighty. Let's celebrate the Almighty, the one that is with us. The young that I am. The Creator of the universe. Can I raise a hand and shout hallelujah? We are greedy.
Oh. See the top of your enemy. Ladies and gentlemen, God is mentor and God is good. Is the God a good God?
Yes.
I ask you, Christian, the God a good God?
Yes.
Is your God a borrower?
No.
Is your God sick?
No.
Is your God a poor God?
No.
Have you heard that your enemy or enemy of this head has heard, have you heard that you have defeated God?
No.
He's a mighty man and God.
Yes.
He's the King of Kings. Ladies and gentlemen, by the grace of God, I will preach it of 3 minutes. In 3 minutes, I will hand over to God. And I want to preach the message I tried to hear. It's so funny, but I want to preach that message today. Romans chapter number 10. You know the Bible says,
amen.
Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. I want to read from NCB. I want to read from King James for me first.
If thou shalt confess with thy mouth,
Lord Jesus, and you believe in your heart
that God has raised him from the dead,
thou shalt be saved.
For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness.
For with the heart
man
believeth unto what? Righteousness. And with the mouth, confession is made unto what? Salvation. Mark that 2 words there. With the heart. He said, my what? Believeth. With your mouth, confession is what? Is made. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I preach a message like that. It's a very long talk, very long there. The distance between you and your success is the length between your heart and your mouth. In other words, your heart and your mouth. Amen.
Amen.
I will celebrate Jesus. How many of us are praying, God bless me? How many of us are saying, God bless me? God promote me. God write my name in the book of life. Come and wave your hand and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now I bring this before you. The distance between you and your success is the length between your heart. Your mouth. Out of the heart, man do what? Believe it. What heart believe? What happened to the mouth? He confessed. Get me? The Bible says, he said the tongue is the smallest organ of the body and very dangerous. And I says again every day, the tongue that good declaring as a man tempted. You are in the position you are today. Not that God put you there. You put yourself there. Everyone. God never created you to be poor or under your enemies. You put yourself there. I preached a message years ago. I tried to failure is by choice. You choose to fail. You fail. A man fall. Does not mean that he's on the ground until you decide to be on the ground. And that is what the Bible said, the righteous man falleth 7 times and do what? Rise. Your blessing and your success lies in your heart and your mouth. You believe that all is done, what do you do? You confess it. You declare it. You show it to people. Romans says here, my Bible, if you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and if you believe in your heart that God raised him, Jesus, from the dead, you what? You are saved. You are saved. You are saved. You are not under satanic condemnation. Romans says, therefore, we are not what? We are not condemned. No condemnation to them who believe in Christ Jesus. And what's the word? Confess that he's Lord. Now, when I begin to say success between you, between your heart, your nose, your mouth, the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth declares. labor. God never give to the rich 26 hours. God never give to the poor 12 hours. He gave us 24 hours. But when you make use of it, determine what will come at the end of the day. And that is what the Bible begins to teach us. That a sower went to the field to sow. Some fell on the good ground. Some fell on the dry land. Now I'm not going there today, but I'm talking about this. Your heart and your mouth. If your heart condemns you, you are condemned. But Jesus said, he said, let not your heart be what? Condemns you. In John, he said, let not your heart be what? Be troubled. Believe. That is the word. Believe in me. And also believe. He said, I leave this earth to prepare a place for you. What will take you to heaven is your heart. What will take you to the kingdom is your heart. That is why I said choose. Choose what? Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I say hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
With mouth we declare it. We confess. What you confess? What you confess is what you possess. What you declare is what you inherit. If you are a believer or a Christian, every day you confess negative things comes as a result. These are not bad for me. Because hell is not a bad door. And these are bad for me. You confess it. Because it comes from where? From your heart. You cannot begin to speak when that thing is not from your heart. First of all, you conceal it. The second one you want, you declare it. You confess it. And things are hard for my family. Oh God, things are hard. And things will be hard. Because it's your confession. Once you believe that things are what? Are hard. And what do you do? You declare it. You confess it. I don't know whether we make it. Look at negative what? Confession. I don't know whether we make it. Tell your neighbor, I must surely make it.
I must surely make it.
You confess it. You know what? You believe what? You know what? You confess. Jesus will act. The presence of God will come in Matthew chapter 12 and chapter 10, verse 32. He talks about your mouth. Your mouth. Please stop using your mouth to destroy yourself. Stop using your mouth to destroy yourself. In any country you are, in any business you are doing, you wake up in the morning, give thanks to who? To God. I think there's a place in the Bible that says, he said, a living dog is better than a dead lion. You give thanks to God. I was saying something in my faith clinic. You use your mouth to praise God. After praising God, you turn after the thought. What do you do with your mouth? You begin to swear, Ogun will kill you. You are swearing Ogun for your child. Because of the mistake. Are you that make mistakes every day before God? God has never caused Ogun to kill you. Me. I don't know the name of the attitude they need. All Ogun will kill you. All Ogun has no power. It is your confession that sets you Ogun to act. It is your confession and your belief to the power of Ogun. It is your confession and the belief to that idol in your village that makes it to act. There is no power in idol. Bible says there is no name given among men through whom the man shall be what? Shall be saved. It's only the name of who? Of Jesus. Come on, lift your hand and shout hallelujah. Yes, I believe. You believe, you know what? You declare it. You confess it. You confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. You believe the word of God. And I know what the scriptures say. Word of God. And I confess that Jesus remains what? Remains Lord. You listen to this. You believe that Jesus is Lord, the power of God will manifest. And I'm going to say this so that we know what I mean.
But we know, when they came travel abroad, and they say they are killing people there, yo, maybe they will kill my Pekin. You are handing your daughter, your son, to the killers. Listen, even though they say, God forbid, it didn't come from your heart. You are already confessing. Confession is what I call here declaration. I say confession means declaration of someone's belief or reason. That is confession. What you believe, you do what? You confess it. What you believe, you do what? You declare it. And that's why David declared, he said, I shall not die. Because he saw all the enemies around him. He said, for that which you promised me, I have not what? I have not yet manifested. I shall not what? Die. I shall live to declare the works of God. He believed the word of God. He knew God. So all you need to do, without a short message, let your heart believe Jesus. Because the Bible says, he made a way where there is no way. The Bible says, one with God is majority. The Bible says, if God be for you, who can be against you? Know this scripture. That is the word of God. You believe, you do what? You confess positively. Positive things, not negative things. No report from against me shall prosper. Any tongue that shall rise against me in judgment, I condemn them. Whether 20 of them gather to condemn you, if God has not condemned you, you are not condemned. Come, I'm talking to you. Can I hear you? Amen. Amen. Somebody say, my heart.
My heart.
Say, my heart.
My heart.
Believe Jesus. You are a student. You are believing what others are saying. Maybe the pastor in university, no talk. And look at that brother that studied economics, accountant. There's no job. And you're believing that confession. You remember that brother. You will be like that brother. And there's no need for me to train my children. Look at that, my sister that trained my children. Nowhere, no job, no job. That is not your possession. What you believe is what you say. I believe that if there are governors in Nigeria, my son, my daughter will grow to become a governor.
Amen.
I don't know whether you hear what I say.
Amen.
God never give me useless children. So if other children, I don't pray that there's no child that is useless. There's no child that is useless. It all depends on the father and the mother confession and their belief. I believe. Yes, I believe. It must be well. Things must change in Nigeria. Nigeria will not continue like this. If God has not given that revelation, he has given that revelation. Nigeria will not continue like this. A time will come, you and I will enjoy this nation.
Amen.
If that is your opinion, can I hear your
amen
with you? Time is coming. Whether men like it or not, whether are using a religion to attack my business. Time will come, the killing will stop. Even the killer will be killed. I don't know whether you hear that word. The killer will be what? Will be killed. The people sponsoring them will be killed by the people that they sponsor. That's your word. And I believe that. That is why I confess it to you. Your success is with you. And next Sunday, by God's grace, I will be preaching a message on that. But it will be touched on Saturday. The preacher will say, how to attack your lack. You need to know that. Very important. Now I continue in John chapter 12, verse 42. I say, I have a friend in the house. They believed on him, but they did not confess him. That's what the Bible says. You can read that. John 12, 42, my friend. John 12, 42. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Among the chief rulers.
Among the chief rulers.
Also,
John chapter 12,
verse 42.
Yes.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
Among the chief rulers.
Among the chief rulers.
Also.
Also.
Many believed on him.
Many believed on him.
But because of the Pharisees.
Because of the Pharisees.
They did not confess him.
They did not confess him.
Lest they should be put out of the synagogue.
So that they will not put them out of the synagogue. That's the church.
Do you hear the reading? He said, many did not believe him. He said, many believe. There are many now. Let me just divide it into two out of 100 of them. 20% believe. Other 80 believe. But they did not confess him. That's what the Bible says. Now, what my reading is, they said, but many believe in Jesus. Even many of the leaders. But because of the Pharisees, they did not say that they believe him for fear. For fear. Now let me bring Nigeria into this message. We have leaders among the senators. They are Christians. Many are Christians. Am I correct, sir? Among the governors, many are Christians. House of Rep, many are Christians. Ministers, many are Christians. They believe in Jesus. That is why they don't go to church. Many pastors believe in Jesus. They go to church, they preach Bible, and they don't confess Jesus. They believe. They don't confess him. Why? If I confess Jesus, the governor will not give me a contract. Confessing, the Bible says, man too, he shall know the fruit, and the truth you know shall say to what? Free. The heart and the mouth for our preaching. They believe, they come to church. You believe, you come to church. Have you confessed Jesus? Have you told people about Jesus? Are you not the one telling men and women around you that there is a man there that can solve your problem? Go to that Babalago, go to that prophet. He marked you with native talk, your life will be free. Marking you with native talk is prisoning your life. Putting your life in what? In bondage. Many of us are afraid to confess Jesus outside the church, even in the church. If I should tell the choir master the truth, he will stop giving me songs. I tell the church leaders the truth. They will transfer me to the village. Even in the village, Christ is in the village. I don't know whether somebody understands what I'm saying. And if I should tell the governor that what he's doing is evil, the governor will remove me among his cabinet. Governor remove you, Christ did not remove you. That is what is causing confusion in family. That is what is causing confusion in Nigeria. They go to church. You see them in the church. I saw many of them in the church yesterday. Central Baptist Church. I saw them. When one of our father, daughter is getting married, I saw many of them. How many of them believe in Christ? They just come purposely to attend the program. Did they confess Jesus? If all the Christians all day in higher position, confessing peace. Children. So we don't have trouble in your family. Even my own husband and wife, my children, my children. The sons will see what the father is doing. He will fail to rebuke him so that the father will stop paying school fees. He will stop paying his school fees. I will not beat them. What will you do? You will join them to her. You will join them to her. Her will receive you. Somebody say, God have mercy.
God have mercy.
You believe, and you know what? You confess. You confess Jesus. You confess him, you saw him. You confess Jesus, people will see the image of Christ, the garment of righteousness all about you. You believe, you confess, Jesus ran and he lived.
Somebody told us something that shocked me and my mama yesterday. Everyone shed tears. A young man in Obese, make money. I don't know whether the family are in the church here, please don't be angry. I'm using it to preach. Make money. He was sending the goods to Nigeria. He will hand it over to the family to sell. They will not give him correct money. Even the money to ship it, they will not give blood to the amount. And he decided to come by himself. As he entered Nigeria, he called one of his friends. That one resign or retire from Navy. And they go around the. And even this young man, he said, he invested 20 million in that goods. 3 trailers. I don't know.
And he bought a land, a house in Sable Road. A bad bought house, not a money. And hand it over to the other sister, the husband. Please take care of this house for me. Go away, disgrace your enemies. Yeah. You know what happened? This young man entered Nigeria, ladies and gentlemen. They just saw him come and eat. One of them shot poison into the food. After he ate, he stopped there. And he called his friend and said, please, can we go to Luku, where we have this custom office there? That's what God has blessed. Formerly Tokate. When they got there, the guy said, I'm very hungry. He said, I don't eat. The Navy man said, I don't eat outside. He said, let me eat here. They entered into Buka. The man was preparing the food. He took a Sprite, Fanta, go, let's go. When the man served the food again, he said, no, I cannot eat again. I'm okay with this. But I was so hungry. They got to that place. They finished everything. They took a loop bypass to Abba Road, straight to Fabler Road. Around 9 p.m., they got home. The young man dropped him and said, good night. I took a cab straight to in place. Around 10, 11, they called him and said, come and explain what you give to our brother to eat. Where are you? So I said, before you go to Central, faith many place. Before I got there, he said, before you came to that faith many place, the young man was lying down lifeless. He cried, heavens and the earth! He cried and cried and cried away. And they put him in the mortuary. And that was the following morning, 6 a.m., about 24 of these men were at his gate. They arrested him and put him in prison. Something is happening somewhere. You should not use your mouth to condemn yourself before your enemies. You should not use your mouth to speak evil. Because the Bible says, every idle word a man speaketh, he shall account for it. Just lay your hand on your heart. Say, Lord, from today, circumcise my heart. If you are one I pray for, can I hear you? Amen. And they paid him with 450,000. I said, this money is not what I'm praying for. Who will not tell the family that I invested 20 million? And before he got to the compound where they have all this food, the family has already collected everything. But the toddler, the friend told him that they can't wait. They took it all. The worst thing that happened, sir, the elder sister now goes straight to the court and change the name, the document for the house to that name. Yeah. And tell you what happened in here. The young man had wife and children in university. Your man's not going to kill you. Come on, lift your hand and say, Lord, save my life.
Lord, save my life.
Continue with us to believe. All right. Can we welcome home to my wife? Sit down. In 2 Timothy, listen to me. Tell mama to stop watching this. Now read for me. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 13 and 12. Now let me read from my Bible here. It says, if we suffer with Christ, we shall also what? Reign with him. Come on, please. Come on. Alter, please. Sit down. If we suffer with Christ, what is it? We shall reign with him. If we deny him, he also shall do what? Shall deny us. 2 Timothy chapter 2, 12 and 13. You suffer with Christ, you reign with Christ. You deny Christ, Christ will also what? Deny you. Listen to that. When we talk about money in the top, many of us deny Christ. And you look back and say, God bless my business. What do you expect him? to do? He denied you.
You go outside, you see people to Bristol, for you to preach Jesus to them.
You join them, you compromise your faith, you deny him already.
And at the time of your need,
Jesus will deny you.
I'm just talking your heart, because it's what you believe.
It's what you confess.
What comes from your heart
is what.
No, people say, wearing a peace one is not a sin. Glory to God.
From your heart, you think of what to put on. Am I correct?
Yes.
Even the garment I wear now, in my wetsuit now, from where? From my heart.
I am not giving offering from where?
From your heart.
And a giver, the Bible says, is a receiver. I'm not going up from the Jerusalem.
It's from your heart. You deny him.
So, whatever you are doing, the first thing you need to do, put him first. The Bible says, seek him first, the kingdom of God, and his what? Righteousness. Every other thing shall be added. So follow. What you are pursuing now is supposed to be with you. You are pursuing money. Money is supposed to stay with you. You are pursuing good health. Good health is supposed to be your inheritance. But today you are tired. Why? You are seeking after worldly things. Living the things of the kingdom. Your mouth and your heart. Stand to your feet.
Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. We continue from where we stop this. Lift up your right hand to God. I ask you a question. The Bible says many of them believe him. That's why you are here. How many of us are ready to confess him? How many of us are ready to tell people about Jesus? How many of us are ready to forsake our business and go for evangelism? Let me remind you, the kingdom of God is at hand. Don't just say, I must go, get married, I must born children, I pray for my grandchildren. It may not be up to that time. Because the Bible says no one knows the date of his coming. And that's why you need to be ready. Ready at all times. Whatever what God has given to you, use it for the kingdom now. Because after now, it might be too late. Lift up your hands and begin to pray for him. So never allow negative thoughts to come in.
Help me.
Never allow negative things to come in. Never allow me to condemn myself.
The
distance between you and your success and success. Distance between you and success when I'm preaching. It does the same between your heart and your heart. If what you believe is what you are confessing,
he
will come to you. You believe Jesus, also confess Jesus.
Lord,
you believe in prosperity,
confess
prosperity by giving.
You are
because whatever a man sows, God shall reap. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want to pray for you if I say. If you are here, let me use this word. You have been denying Christ when it comes to money, when it comes to evangelism, when it comes to giving, when it comes to time. You have been denying him because you are after your own. I want you to change your mind. Whatever you give, I think the brother sent it to me. I said it on Thursday. I said it around the place. Anytime he's going to work, he will stop by Catholic. He never attended church. He never go anywhere. But one day, something entered into his spirit. As he was passing, he walked to the church and greet God. Good morning, sir. That was the Christ. He said, let me go and greet Christ. He started doing it not after many years. After that, this man got an accident. And that's it affected his spinal cord. And they took him to hospital. He was there for many months. As the wife went out to buy food for him and for herself, he said, suddenly, a man that went white
came into the hospital room and also said, "Brother, I've come to greet you. I greet you, receive your healing." That was all. The man disappeared. As the woman, the wife came in and saw the husband sitting on the bed, he said, the wife shouted, "See, it's a ghost," and ran away and raised alarm. Doctors and nurses came. When the doctor saw him, the doctor went back. I said, "Can this be a ghost?" I began to ask him questions. And the man answered and told them what happened to him. Greeting in the house of God turned as a seed and a soul. I told you how Christian Ronaldo mother, what did he do in the church? He sued the church. Today, God has made a son a star. Your words is also a seed. You are the house of God for the hands and waiting for your date of death, so that they will use your mother's mothership card if do you pay to bury you. Church bury you, church not bury you, that one cannot take you to the kingdom. The amount of money you fold and begin to his. Pastor, no way to happen. I know. What you sow, you fold him, you get nothing. You give, you get something. I pray for you. That's really that I've been disturbing you, not to sow. In evangelism, in giving for kingdom, I command that spirit to die. Yeah. And anything that wants to sponsor your heart to think evil, to reason evil, and to confess negative things that want to rise to our faith or stop you tomorrow, I command that thing to be arrested. Yeah. As you believe in, anywhere you go, you need to confess it. Yeah. You believe in prosperity, you give. You confess it. Let even our nation Nigeria, men that are in position, I pray for you that it is because of the Pharisees and the Sadducees, for you, for them not to put you out or pull you out from the cabinet, from the house of assembly or senate, today I command that spirit to leave you. Yeah. I pray for you in the vaccine, because of the woman that sponsored you, and they have been threatening you with Ayala, with different child, and because of that you never have time to serve God. I command that spirit and ask you to disappoint them in the name of Jesus. We make way for you. Thank you for Nigeria.
Thank you
for the church of
earth.
In Jesus' name, can I get a loud amen from the believers?